I'm happy to state that we have made substantial progress and have already implemented four very major reforms in the existing system. The first, the present system did not have the process where accountability could be fixed to a particular individual on who was booking the bed and which bed was booked by which individual in the war room. Now, we have institutionalized individual IDs for every single person working in the war room who is booking a bed. So next to the bed that is allotted, the person, the doctor who's making the bed booking, his name will figure. For example, this is a patient who's been allotted a bed in Victoria Hospital. The doctor from Bengaluru South Zone, Dr. Dhruva U. Gowda, is the person who has booked this bed. So this will fix accountability on people who are booking beds for patients in the war room. The second important reform that we have already instituted is the SMS alert to all people, to patients, the moment a bed is allotted in their name. Earlier, a very a crude method way of intimating patients of their allotment was in place, where a screenshot would be sent and a call would have gone, but this was resulting in a lot of delays. Now, the system will auto-generate an SMS upon allotment of a bed to a patient, and that SMS will suffice for admission in a hospital. The third important change that has already been made is, earlier, the amount of time that a patient had from allotment of a bed to admission in a hospital was 10 hours. This was a very long period of time and was giving way for a lot of misuse. Now, this period has been reduced from 10 hours to 4 hours. So, upon allotment of a bed, a patient gets 4 hours to get himself admitted. If he does not, then the bed immediately auto-allots itself in the vacant quota, gets lapsed, and is available for allotment to another individual. The fourth important measure that has already been institutionalized is, we recognized that the process of manual unblocking of beds was leading to a lot of irregularities. So this loophole in the system was misused by a few people, and they would use a person who was, say, in a home isolation, or a person who was even discharged, to as a proxy to book the bed in their name and later manually unblock it to block it in favor of someone else.